Sean has actually, you know, lived, I've just been out there reporting, talking to people. Sean is fantastic for a hard time. He's actually lived a life, so you're going to hear it right from the horse's mouth here. Sean, absolutely fascinating, your description of the prison gangs in the US. I mean, not just in a UK jail, but in a US jail. And tell me something. I know a little bit about the gangs in the UK and how they form, but I'm fascinated how the gangs actually structured in the US.
It's all divided racially. So I was classified to a medium security remand jail. That's where I started out, called Towers, and it was whites, blacks, Mexicans, and Mexican Americans. So whatever street gang you were in is all out the window. Whatever race you're in, you must join that. Not join the gang. You can join it. You must play along with it or else they will smash you. As soon as you go in, because I'm white, the Aryan Brotherhood came up to me right away and said, you must go to the white boy meetings or else we will smash you for failing to represent your race. They also ask you what your charges are. Some charges are KOS by the gang, which means kill on sight, such as paedophile stuff. Other charges are SOS, which means smash on sight. So once you got through this initial interrogation by the gang, then you have to go to the meeting and meet what's called the head of the race. All the races do this, and he explains all the rules you must follow, or else the whole gang will smash you. If someone calls you a punk, a bitch, or hits you, you must fight them on the spot, or else the whole gang will smash you. You must take showers, or else they'll smash you for having bad hygiene. Can't go make friends with the guards, or else they'll smash you for sleeping. Can't go sitting at the tables in the day room of the other races, or else they'll smash you for that. Everything you take for granted about your safety in society is reversed in prison. They're constantly looking for people to beat up, because that's how they earn their reputations and their tattoos. Where I was at, it was called putting work in to earn your political ink. The more serious the act of violence they commit, higher up in the gang hierarchy are the tattoos that they earn. So not only are they looking for people to beat up, they're looking to inflict maximum damage. For example, the Aryan Brotherhood, if you collect a debt or beat someone up, you might get a swastika or SS lightning bolt. To join the Aryan Brotherhood, to be a full-fledged member, to get the Warbird tattoo, you have to murder someone in the jail for the gang. Yeah, if you classify all the murders in America right now by who's causing them, Aryan Brotherhood is the biggest one. Italian Mafia are contracting these guys when they get out of prison to do their hits. There's a lot of documentaries on YouTube you can see about it. It's all very real.
You've got some great pictures, and I've seen some of your YouTube stuff. And tattoos is a very important part of it. I mean, are those the important ones, or are there others that mean different things?